Save my soul, lost in a shadow, need a miracle. Locked in a battle, I was on my own, living in yesterday. Yeah. Let's take it all the way.
Good morning, Wolfpack. I'm Jacob Farrell.
And I'm Ryan Nguyen, and we're here with your morning announcements.
And I'm Brady Gomez with Promise Johnson, and we'll be bringing you your sports update.
Starting off with club news, FBLA is having a meeting this Friday after school in HG2. They will be having another guest speaker, so all members should make sure to be there.
Lead Latino Club invites you to participate in their fourth annual Day of the Dead art contest. You can create artwork of any style as long as it's based on the Dia de los Muertos theme. Your work has to be original and colorful. Scary or bloody artwork will not be accepted. Please turn in your artwork in HM1 or to your Spanish teacher by November 1st. There will be prizes for the best and most original artwork. Here are some picks. There are prizes, diplomas, and extra credit for winners.
Attention CSF members, the next meeting will be on Wednesday, November 1st at 8:15 a.m. in the choir room.
The Joy Club is hosting a donation drive for Samaritan's Purse Operation Christmas Child. This donation is to collect toys and other miscellaneous items for kids in need. Boxes have been set up in HJ7, the choir room, Library 1, and in the office. The list of items acceptable can be found on each of the boxes. Make sure to stop by and donate.
And now, Promise and Brady are going to talk to you about sports.
How's it going, guys? Let's start off with some football news for you all today. The team will be playing an away game against Whitney on Friday, starting at 7:15 p.m. Come out and show your support.
Now for volleyball. The team had their senior night last Thursday, and we're bringing you the highlights. Here we have number 2, Olivia Prince, as she hits the ball and is then hit again by number 5, Haley Berto. Now Marlena and Jesse tell what they missed the most about the team.
I'm going to miss the team the most because all the girls are really great and they always make me laugh no matter what.
I'm going to miss the traveling we did. We went to Reno, we went to all over, and we were traveling a lot, and I was able to bond with the girls more, and we definitely, during those bonding, we build more of our friendship, and I'm going to miss that the most.
Thank you, guys.
The team had a great season this year, and the juniors are looking forward to play again next season.
Now for cross country. The team will be having their CVC finals at Maidu Park on Friday. Reinhard Wolpeck.
With the fall athletic season coming to a close, our CO student athletes are working hard not only on the court, field, and course, but also in the classroom.
Our CO fall athletic teams earned an overall GPA of 3.41. The team with the third highest GPA was girls JV volleyball with a GPA of 3.67. In second place, the cross country team finished with a GPA of 3.86. Finally, the girls' tennis team finished with the highest fall sports GPA 2 years in a row with a GPA of 4.01. Nice job, Wolfpack, and make sure to keep those grades up.
That concludes our sports announcements for today. Now back to Jacob and Ryan for the rest of your announcements.
Anyone interested in trying out for boys' or girls' basketball, boys' or girls' soccer, or boys' or girls' wrestling must complete an athletic clearance packet. Packets are available in the main office or from the athletic director in HD5.
If you already have a clearance packet on file with the athletic director, please pick up a red packet. And if this is your first sport you are trying out for this year, please pick up a white packet. Winter clearance nights are next Wednesday, November 1st, and Thursday, November 2nd, in room HC6 from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m.
In other news, if you are interested in going to Japan next year, here's the opportunity for you. You can access the program and the application on the Japanese class website or talk to Ms. Tanaka in HM5. Applications are due November 17th.
Attention all student drivers, your parking spot is not assigned to you. Please remember that all orange and blue spots are available to both students and adults. Asking a student or adult to leave from their spot will result in a loss of parking privileges.
We have our first ever parent lunchie on this Friday, October 27th. So be sure to let your parents know what lunch you have so they can bring you food and enjoy a day of music, games, and more.
Boograms are available in the MP room during both lunches. Send a fun message to your friend along with a Kit Kat. They are $2 and will be sold at a table in the cafeteria.
Well, that's all we have for you today. I'm Jacob Farrell.
And I'm Ryan Nguyen. Remember, the strength of the pack is the wolf.
And the strength of the wolf is the pack.
Farewell, my dudes.